this little unit is a godsend.
I couldn't get my camera, so it's locked in my...
Let me know if you hear me over there.
Okay.
The vice unit for the Anaheim Police Department is setting up at a local hotel.
Do you want to take this?
Shane, the undercover officer in the white shirt, is getting ready for a date. And he's nervous.
Let's swap rooms.
Well, this room is better because you can see it from the lot.
Yeah, but you can see him walk by you. If this is the cold room, you'll see them pass right by this window going to that room.
Yeah, but you're gonna have people out in the lot. They're going to tell you that she's walking up to the room. Okay.
The cold room is where the arrest team sits and waits for what's called the bust signal. About an hour ago, Shane contacted a woman who was offering services online. In the delicate dance over the phone, he got her to agree to provide sex for money.
How much for an hour? Is it still $160? Okay, and that's full service, right?
And one way he made sure he knew what was being offered is by asking about the one thing that would only be used if sex were taking place.
Do I need to bring condoms or do you already have them? You have them? Okay.
This is Anaheim's way of making sure a criminal violation is recorded before contact is even made.
Investigator, I will be calling back a female.
Shane then got a hotel room and told the girl he would wait for her there. What she doesn't know is that she's not meeting a client, but six undercover investigators, an FBI agent, patrol officers, and a victim services representative. The team holds a briefing before Shane heads into the room to wait.
So do you want to say when she's in the room, just hit it, or...
Sure. Yeah, just come in the room.
Once the door closes, hit it.
You know, give me some time in there. Because if we small talk and she wants me to pay her out then,
okay. And
then the pimp comes to break her, then we'll get the pimp
at
the door.
Three investigators are in the room next to Shane, monitoring his wire and looking out for anybody who might resemble Shane's date. Other investigators and the FBI agent watch the outside of the hotel. After more than an hour of waiting and false alarms, the date is spotted.
All right, Shane's going to be directing her to the room.
She's alone, but did someone drive her there? At the most critical moment, the wire in Shane's room dies. A quick decision's made to call Shane's cell phone and have him leave it in his pocket so the arrest team can hear what's being said. But that proves to be frustrating, as they nearly miss the code words, "Let's party," that tells the team he's made a deal, and they can make a bust.
I think he said we can party without him.
F*** it. We got our father.
The team moves in and learns Shane's date is only 17, a juvenile, which could mean a tough sentence for whoever dropped her off at the hotel.
But I haven't met a single prostitute that at one time in his or her life hasn't been under the control of a pimp. And meaning that 100% of them are all working as a prostitute and at one point or time seeing no monetary compensation.
Since the girl is under age 18, it's suspected she's working for a pimp. Finding that person becomes the team's main focus. For the CNN Freedom Project, I'm Martin Savage.